and I have the Spirit of Jesus, the Holy Ghost, living inside of us, and we have a working, living relationship with the Lord Himself. Somebody ought to shout the praises of God right there and give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. He said he was clothed in a robe down to his feet, girded about his paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hair was white like wool. His eyes were as flaming fire, and his feet as fine brass that had been tried in the furnace. John got a new revelation this day of who Jesus is. Hallelujah. If there's ever been a day that we need a new revelation of who Jesus is, it is the day we live in. I believe we as Christians need to make some resolutions. But before we make resolutions, we need some revelations. We need God to give us a new revelation of who Jesus is. Amen. We need to know who this man is in a new light and a new revelation. We need God to stir us up again with His Spirit and His power. Amen. In our hearts and lives. We need a new revelation in our lives of who we are in Christ Jesus. And I find that in this chapter right here. Him that loved us and washed us in His own blood. Well, praise the Lord. Do you get that, church? Do you get that? Do you get that? Unto Him that loved us and washed us in His own blood. Do you know tonight, child of God, that you're the head and not the tail? Amen. That's the Word of God. You are the head and not the tail. David said, I was young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Do you know tonight who you are in Jesus? If two of us agree, if me and you agree on any one thing, whatsoever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Did you know that? I'm here to tell you that if the church in America will come together and we'll begin to pray, we can change, amen, this nation for the glory of God. And we need it. God's saying to you and I tonight, don't be afraid. I've got my hand on you. You're my child. I'll protect you. I'll defend you. I'll deliver you. Don't be afraid. We need a new revelation of who the devil is and what he's up to within our lives. Amen. I want you to know, child of God, Satan hates you tonight. He hates you. He don't hate the sinner. He don't hate the ungodly. He don't hate the wicked. He's already got them, but he hates you, child of God, because you're the property of God Almighty, and he hates God, and because he hates God, he hates you. Peter said, be sober, be vigilant, for your adversary, the devil, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. And I want you to know tonight, friend, he is on your heels. And he knows how to trip you up. He knows how to lie. Jesus said, when he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of himself, for he's a liar and the father of it. He invented the lie. You can't outdo him because he created the lie. Let me give you a new revelation tonight of who Satan is. He's a defeated foe. He's a defeated enemy. God's already beat him. The Lord whooped him on Calvary. Amen. Jesus defeated him when he came out of the tomb. If we want to change this nation, we need to bring Jesus back in. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here's what we need in America.